So what's up guys, today in this video I'll be taking you through the Remita payment platform. The Remita payment platform is what a lot of people use to pay for their tax fees. Lawyers use it a lot when they are registering something at CAC. So I'll be taking you through the Remita platform online, and you can actually do a lot of amazing things on this. You can actually pay for your employee salary through the Remita platform and do quite a lot of things in it. And Remita platform is actually not owned by a Nigerian government, it's actually owned by a private company. So I'll take you to the website and everything you need to know about the Remita payment platform. But before I take you there, don't forget to smash the subscribe button. Let's get to 10,000 subscribers before the end of this month so that we can reach a lot of people and also make exciting videos than this.
Remita is now owned by the federal government. It's actually a private company. It's a fintech company that allows you to send money to third parties, to send money to vendors, to different people. Maybe you want to do a money transfer, or maybe you want to pay bills. Now there are different platforms where Remita works. Now you can use Remita for a point of sale, that's POS, point of sale terminal, or you can use it to pay your employees. Maybe you want to pay your staffs at the end of the month, or you want to pay tax. You can also use the TSA account under the Remita platform to pay for your tax. Then if you want to pay for your school fees as well, you can also use that to pay for your school fees, either federal government, university, state government, or any local government institutions recognized by the federal government. Now apart from that, you can also use it to collect loans. So if you need loans, you can also use Remita to apply for loan. But before you can do that, you need to open an account and you must have used it for a period of time. Then also you can also use it to pay bills, maybe your electricity bills, or maybe you want to transfer money to anybody, so you can also use it as well. So these are several things that you can use Remita for. So you don't use Remita only for payment of corporate or payment of federal government fees, whether into TSA account. You also use it for personal things. In fact, by the time you open your Remita account, there are four different sections you can open an account with. You can either open an account as a personal person, or a single signatory, or a multi-signatory, or federal government account. So there are four different sections you can open an account for, and I'll be explaining to you whether you should open an account with any of those sections. So if you are new to Remita, all you need to type is Remita and then you click on it, and once you click on it, it takes you to this particular business page, and then you click on it. So immediately you click on it, it takes you to this website. Now I've used this Remita for a long of time because I do a lot of registrations for companies and so on and so forth like that. So I've changed through the website and what I think about it. Now I like that design, is a good design. However, one of the issues I have with it is that I've been using it for a long time, and so I've not really seen a lot of development in terms of their sign up page. So I think that a lot of things can still be put here. You could make it more explanatory for people. You can always update it, build more templates, let people see that this is what you are doing. For example, you see some software company, they say sign up, send your money, and we charge to use it. So I think a lot of things should be coming up on here, a lot of things should be popping up on here, just to make people know that they are actually active on their website. So that's the first thing that you should know about Remita. However, it empowers customers to pay you easily as you grow. Then of course you're able to generate greater income. So once you use Remita, for example, you generate more money, then of course you achieve much more as a white man. So you are able to reach much more people by using Remita platform. Like I said before, you are able to also pay for electricity bills with any of those registered with them. So it has to be registered with them. So for example, EEDC, a co electricity transmission company, and so on and so forth like that, I've registered with them. So that's why you are seeing it here like that. And then of course, very important for you to know that you might don't necessarily need to be using the website. You can download the app on your phone and it will make it as easy as possible for you. So if you are using an iPhone, you can download on Apple Store, and if you have an Android phone, you can also download it on Google Play. Now, like I've always told people, if you want to open any stock account, or if you want to open any website at all, one of the first things that you should check is your customer care, their privacy policy, their terms and conditions, and their documentations, whether it is up to date. Now if you want to check for the privacy policy of Remita, you have to scroll down, then under this privacy page you click on it. We might not be going into details into the privacy policy on terms and conditions, but I just want to really explain something to you about that. Then their customer care, you can call them. There are two numbers there that you can call, and although I've not tried calling them before because I've not needed them, and that's a good thing on their own part. I've not needed them, but I hope that their customer care is always good. So if you want to open an account with Remita, I think you should try and call their customer care, because there are always issues with fintech companies or software. So if they have a good customer care, I think that I'll be able to rely on the company and continue to use their software. Then of course, if their phone number is not going, you can send them a mail. But for me, I prefer to call them and get an instant redress to any issues I'm facing. Then of course, if you're in Lagos and you are close by, you can visit them at their office and make a complaint to them in case you have issues with it. So on their privacy policy, you have quite a lot of things: their privacy consent, personal information. Like I said before, if you want me to make a video on the privacy policy of Remita, you can just type it on the comment below before you register your account. Then of course, how you protect your personal data, then access to data, then security, the data confidentialities, then limitation of liabilities, and then queries and questions. If you have any issues in respect to any transaction you did, maybe you sent money and it has not arrived, you can call them or you can send mail to them with their email address, support@remita.net. Now, one of the issues I always have with a lot of software companies or fintech companies is the fact that they always limit their liabilities so that in case there's a breach, for example, they are not liable to that breach, which I think is quite wrong. In fact, most of the time, by the time I read their terms and conditions, I find it almost impossible for them to be liable to any liability. And I think that these are some of the things CBN should always look at before they give them license in case there's a breach and so on and so forth. But I've read Remita terms and privacy policy and I'm not seeing anything as to insurance here. So that's one thing I think they should actually look for and resolve, because there will always be issues of hack and so on and so forth. So what will happen if you have been hacked and let's say they got my password through your platform and they access my information and withdraw from my account? Are you not going to be liable to pay me? Or in case you have insured it, of course the bank or the insurance company will pay you. So I think that they should include an insurance cover here so that in case there is a breach, you'll be able to get your money back as soon as possible. Then also on their terms and conditions, they have payment of salary. So under the terms and conditions, it actually states what they do. They pay salaries, you can pay taxes, they can pay for pensions and so on and so forth like that. So we will really go into details into it by the time we sign up for the account. Now if you want to sign up for Remita, all you need to do is go to sign up and click on sign up. So now once you click on the sign up, it is what it will show on the website. So you can either sign up, like I said before, you can sign up as a personal person, a sole signatory, a multi-signatory, or a government. Now explain what all the four means. Now for personal, that's if you have not registered your company, but maybe you wrote a book and you want to sell it out to the public, and you want the public to pay for the book through a platform. So you can open a personal account, put your name and your information there, so that by the time people buy your book, they pay directly to your Remita account, and from there it can go to your personal account. So that's what personal means. Now for sole signatory, let's assume you have registered a company or a business, and maybe you want to pay your employees salary, or you want to use it for a transaction, you can open sole signatory. Sole signatory basically means that you are the only signatory to their account. Then of course you have multi-signatory. So let's assume there are a bunch of directors in the company. You have director, you have secretary, and you want all of them to be signatories to the account. For example, if you want to sign any contract, now you need two directors of the company, or a director and a secretary. So in that regard, you can open a multi-signature account so that in case one of the directors dies or leaves the firm, one person will still be able to sign and log in into the account. So that's basically what it means. So signature allows just only you to log into the account. Multi-signature allows more than one person, so that even if you want also to do a transaction, you need the authorization of the first signature and then the second signature. Then finally is the government. Now personal persons cannot open account under here. It's only government, ministries, department and agencies, MDAs, that can open account under here. So like I said before, you can pay for your institution fees if it's a federal government university or state government university. So you can pay for it under here. I know for UNILAC you can pay for it, for OAU you can pay for it also. And also if you want to make any tax payment or want to file any tax payment, you can also pay for it under this account. So this account can only be opened, like I said before, by any government agency. So a personal person cannot open the account. Now I'll take you step by steps on how to make that payment and everything you see on the platform. Now if you want to open an account, for example, let's click on personal. So it's like the normal process of opening an account for any other website. So you put your information here, your email and your phone number, and you click on these two, and then finally you click on proceed. So once you click on proceed, what happens is that you fill some personal information that will include your name, your information, what you want to be doing, is it a business, and so on and so forth. That is why it's very important that if you don't have a business, you shouldn't open a multi or single signature account, because by the time you open it, the information will fill, will contain part of your certificate and housing number of your company and so on and so forth. And because you don't have that, you will actually be put to a stop. If you don't have that, that is what personal account is for. So once you open your personal account, they send a message to your email based on the email you put in. And once you click on proceed, you'll be able to open an account for you. So if you want to log into your Remita account, all you need to do is type Remita and then click on enter, just like I did on Google. And then, and once you click on the first page, you go to login, because I've registered my account before, so I'm not going to be registering it again. So you click on the login page, and so once you click on the login page, you put your details, your email, and then your password, and then you press sign in. Now, one of the good things I like about Remita is that it takes you to a page where they send a link to either your phone or your email. So that link they sent to your email is what you use to register. So it's a two-password protected stuff. So you put your email first of all, then of course you also put the link they sent to your email. So for me, because I've been used to this, so I'll click on the second method, and they just sent a link to my email. So I just got the link to my email. I'm leaving it blank because of course I don't want you guys to see it. And I click on submit. So once I click on submit, it goes to my website. So this is how the interface of Remita looks like. This is how good it looks like. Now, I think that just like I said at the first page, that it is a bit too dull for me. Much more information should be here. Maybe recent news could be there and add more information. So it's a bit too dull for me, and it's not really showing that they are doing something or they are working on it. So I really think that much development should be done in this, because I've been using Remita for a while now, for about 2 years, and this is what I've always been seeing in their website. But I think they should begin to find a way to add more, spice it up. Now, this is what you will see. Like I said before, you can do your transfer, money transfer, you can pay for DSTV, your cable, your DSTV, and so on and so forth. Then of course, if you want to buy airtime, you can also do that. Then if you want to buy data, if you want to pay for your electricity bills, you can also do that with Remita. Then of course, if you want to pay Remita biller, maybe you want to pay it to CAC or want to generate it, you can also pay as easy as possible. Then of course, this is for the overview. Then you have account and balances. Account and balances just tells you how much you have in your account, how much you have transferred. Then of course, under the account and balances, you have add account. This is where you can add your credit card account, your bank, whether you're using UBI, Access Bank, or any bank that you are using. Then view balances means view the your transaction, your profit, the money you have sent to people over time for months and years, as the case may be. Under payment shows every transaction you can do on your Remita. Now for me, I think that instead of putting payment here, I think the payment ought to be at the overview. The overview has this information as well. So under the overview, you have something like this. So I really feel that there's no difference between this overview and the payment. But of course, I don't know what they were trying to do when they were doing that. But going back to payments, like I said, you can buy airtime, you can buy data, you can pay for electricity bills. So for example, if you click on the electricity companies that have registered under ease, whether it's RCCG Electrical Power Department, whether it's Ports Otakot Electricity Distribution Companies, so you can pay for any of those ones and it's good to go like that. So once you click back, then of course, if you want to transfer to anybody, so this is where you do transfer to people you send the accounts to pay from. So if you are using either UBA, Wema Bank, or so on and so forth, then of course, the account number, you fill all this information, then you pay on send payment, and it's as easy as that. You can pay RI invoice. So you want to pay your RI invoice, you can also do it here. Then if you want to pay tickets for movies, you want to watch movies, but I really think that they don't have enough cinemas for you to pay ticket. For example, if you click on it, the last time I checked it, it was Quara Cinema that I saw, Ilorin, yes. So I really think that they should really do more in terms of a cinema, so that you can pay in any state you are in. You can check for a cinema, click on it, and watch any movie that you want to watch. So I think they should really do more on that, because these are some of the things that drives people to their website, apart from pay, bills and TSA. Then of course, standing order and direct debit to biller. So if you want to send money to people, you can also do it through this means. Then of course, if you want to collect receipt, now the meter has helped me in a scenario before. There was a time I made a payment, I did a transaction through their platform, and I couldn't get the receipt because maybe I mistakenly deleted the receipt. Now what I did was I went back to the platform, I put the Remita reference number, because I could still get the Remita reference number. I wrote it down and then I put it on their platform, and unfortunately for me, they printed the receipt and I was able to submit it. I was able to get the job done. So that's one of the advantages of using Remita platform. Even if you don't get the receipt, you can just type the information and then to bring out the receipt or generate a new receipt for you, backdating it to that date that you made the payment. Then of course, you can request funding. So like I said, you can also apply for loans through the Remita platform. So if you need loan to use it for any project at all, you can also apply for loans and they'll give you loan. But one of the criteria for it is that you must have opened the account and must have been using it over time, and then of course you must have included your salary earning. Lest I forget, you must be a salary earner, so that immediately your salary is coming inside the deduct the loan that you have applied for, maybe per month or per year as you have applied for it. But what Remita does is per month actually, so they deduct your money per month. So it must be your salary earning, and then once you send your information, they check it, and once they know that it's your salary account, they can be deducting the money per month. So that's basically everything you need to know about that. Then of course, this one tells you about the report, your outflow, your inflows, your expense reports, your activities log. So the report just tells you about the activities that you have been doing over time. The most used platform under the Remita is the pay bills and the TSA. So if the pay bills and the TSA is used by lawyers, if you want to file anything, or if you want to make payment, you think single treasury account, or you want to file for taxes, if you want to file things in court, that's where you also make payment, and so on and so forth like that. So if you want to make payment on it, all you need to do is click on the pay bills and TSA. TSA actually means single treasury account. So once it has loaded, it will bring it to this particular page. So once it brings it to this particular page, then under this information is what you put the amount that you're supposed to pay there. You must have gotten prior knowledge of the amount. For example, let's assume you want to pay to University of Abuja. All you need to do is type University of Abuja, Abuja, and then you click on it, and then once you click on it, you put the amount you want to pay, what you want to pay it, whether your school fees, whether it's sciences or mail hostel or any of the fees. Once you do that, then you select the amount. You must have known the prior amount you are supposed to pay, then play the amount, then it will put the total here, the amount, select the expense type. So it will show the expense type, because you have not filled the information, that's why it's not showing the expense type. Then you click on submit. So once you click on submit, it will, you pay to the Remita reference, and then it will transfer to the single treasury account. And once it transfers to single treasury account, you have made your payment, and that's how you use it. Don't forget that you can not just make payment to TSA account, you can make payments, you can buy airtime, you can buy data, you can buy electricity, you can pay for your cable, you can get your receipts, you can but before you do all those things, you need to upload your account details. So it is this place that you add your account details, like I explained before, and once you have uploaded your account details, you are good to go. And then finally, if you want to change your password or manage your account status, if you want to upgrade from personal account, you know, like I said before, there are four sections under the Remita account detail. You have personal, you have single signature, you have multiple signatures, and then we have federal government account. Now if you want to upgrade from personal to maybe single signature or double signature, you have to click on here, then you upgrade your account, and then you are good to go. So that's basically everything you need to know about the Remita platform.
If you like this content and you want to see more of it, don't forget to smash the subscribe button and click on the notification button, so that anytime I release videos like this, you'll be the first to see it.